Insights Media.
Civil society organization Osun Masterminds has revealed plans of contacting the anti-graft agencies to take a look at the books of the Osun State House of Assembly under the Speaker Adewale Egbedun, following failure to deliver on a Freedom of Information request on the use of some funds. The executive director of the organization, Professor Wasiu Edokunwale, made this known at the January edition of the State of the State address before newsmen on Tuesday in Oshogbo.
Anti-graft agencies to come and take a look at the books of the Osun State House of Assembly under Honorable Adewale Egbedun. If it's bigger than us, it cannot be bigger than agencies of government saddled with the responsibility of fighting corruption. We must state, however, that it's an act of irresponsibility and ignorance of correct democratic culture and behavior for a young Speaker of the State Assembly to ignore calls for accountability and probity. We are deeply saddened that a young new entrant into the public service is acting in such a manner.
Speaking further on crime and justice in the state, he condemned the state government's approach in tackling the recent ongoing strike action undertaken by the Judicial Staff of Union of Nigeria, JUSUN.
Closure of courts in Osun State. Since drama broke out in the state judiciary in November 2023, orchestrated by the state government's attempt to illegally remove the state chief judge, the judiciary in Osun has been lifeless, especially due to the strike action declared by the now ousted leadership of the Judicial Staff Union of Nigeria, JUSUN, in the state. While the internal politics of JUSUN is not our immediate concern, the continued closure of the courts due to a strike action declared by the union is mindless and antithetical to the maintenance of law and order, as well as true dispenser of justice in the state. It is further instructive that the Osun State government has been acting nonchalant about the continued closure of the courts. Where a government is not tactically encouraging an industrial action, it will be seen making effort to resolve all issues that may have led to the industrial action in the first place. The Osun State government has, however, remained silent, continued to pay judicial workers' salaries, and looking away from the current total paralysis of the courts in the state. We should remind the Osun State government that while justice system is already a very important arm of a government, the courts serve more purpose than that. There are people whose livelihoods rely on the courts. There are many businesses that thrive on the activities of the courts. More importantly, there are innocent people awaiting trial who have been left to languish in prison because some people are using their lives to settle scores. The state government must, not minding that it got its ego bruised in its attempts to remove the chief judge, immediately make efforts to get the strike in the state judiciary called off. We cannot paralyze a whole arm of the government because we need to prove a point.
Member of the organization, Eldeji Ologun, also called on the state government for immediate intervention in the Ilobua and Ifon Osun crisis.
The country. And we are seeing a fiction of it by the crisis that broke out in Ifon Ilobu less than 72 hours ago. One would have thought that a responsible government would have put an end to the crisis in that zone of the state permanently. Because you will recall that this is not the first. If my record does not serve me wrong, this should be the third resurgence of that crisis between Ilobu and the people of Ifon Osun. At the point, curfew was declared. By the time the curfew was relaxed, one would have thought that the government had had the grip of the situation of things in that zone of the state. But unfortunately, there has been a resurgence and loss of life. Insecurity does not have a map. It can be triggered from any point and spread faster than anybody can imagine. So nobody should believe that, oh, it's an affair of the Ifon and the local people. That crisis is enough to engulf this whole state. And that's why we are holding the state government responsible. The governor swore to an oath to protect lives and property of the people. Ifon, Ilobu, and all that part of the state are not an exception. And the governor needs to sit tight in ensuring that no life is lost and no property is destroyed. You can compensate people whose houses are got burnt or whose farmland got burnt. How do you compensate for a life that you have no idea of what or who that person will have become in the future? Unfortunately, somebody in the ruling class, in the royalty, was killed in this recent clash, a bale or one of the chiefs in that town. So you expect that the people will lose one of their leaders and will not be reactions? And that is why the state government needs to sit up to ensure that whatever it will cost her, security of the people and property of the people of this state is not something with which politics should be played. It should be absolute. And anything short of that would amount to failure of the delegate-led administration.
The organization commended the state government on recent infrastructure development across the state. From Oshogbo, Modupeola, Showmin, Silings TV.
Insights Media.